That would have happened. I mean, I knew. Not bad. Well, I just had to take my. All right. Good morning, everybody. Welcome back to the channel. Let me show you guys what I'm working on. Bam. Airbags. So last night I pre-assembled this one. Probably 99% complete. This is my first time doing something like this. So this is going on my 2020 Ram 3500 dually. It's out there. I'll show you guys later. This is my F450. Man, this truck was awesome. And it still doesn't have too much miles since 230,000. Just got to do a couple of repairs on it. But it acts like a table because I don't have one in here yet. As you guys can see. So a lot of projects. 7500. XLs, and I also ordered that wireless one airlift compressor, which is sweet. I'm excited because I don't have to just in the morning, you know, put 30 pounds in my bags and go from there. I could, if I'm empty, I could drop it to 15 pounds, 5 pounds, whatever is going to be the best ride empty. I put a heavy load on and bump it up, you know, I unload, put something smaller on. It's super adjustable, so I'm excited for that. Hopefully by the end of the day we could get this project done. People usually say it takes about 3-4 hours, but we'll see. But yeah, so this is what we got going on. All right, there you go. So these have to be hand tight. And you know, the bottom ones under here have to go really tight with 9/16, or not really tight. I think you gotta put like 10 pounds. But it says in the instructions, I don't have a torque wrench, which I wish I did, but I'm kind of gonna snug it in and kind of go from there. The next step is to jack up the truck because you want to give space between the bump stop and the axles. All right, see how she goes. All right, next step, take the bump stops off on both sides because you're not gonna need them anymore because the airbag system is gonna be over here somewhere. So I took the bump stops off on both sides, and then I put the airbags in. This is the driver's side, and it's easier to put them in from the front of the axle. Just set this bracket on and then compress the airbag and push it in. Be really careful with this vent line right here. As you can see, the axle vent, super close when you put them in, and also the brake lines. They are very, not flimsy, but they bend very easy, so be careful with this when you're putting this one in. When you're gonna be pushing it from the top, make sure you slip that bolt in behind it, and then carefully put it in. To put in the U-bolt, you know, put this bracket on, and then tighten the U-bolt, and then this lower bracket nice and tight. That goes to 10 pounds, this goes to 16 pounds. Well, I hand tightened with the ratchet in a socket because I don't have a torque wrench, which I should get. And I already put this one in, but I didn't install it yet. It's just in here loose. So this one went in way easier, the passenger side. So I'm gonna assemble it and let's see. If you guys never used the gear wrenches with this ratcheting end, you guys are missing out big time. It makes it so much easier. Look at that, bam. Way easier. All right, the next step is gonna be you gotta grab these braces and then these darker bolts. And then you put the bolts through them and then you drop the truck so that the axle is higher to the top of the truck. So the truck sits on top of these so you could bolt it in. Got the airbags installed. Everything tightened up. Don't forget to tighten these, align the bags, then tighten these bolts, both sides. And then, pretty simple, put the bracket in, put the bolts in. So, and then don't forget to run your air vent tube back, because when you're installing the bags, you gotta get it out of the way. It just goes back. So, cool, so let's work on the air compressor. Alright, so this is the wireless one air compressor. Comes with three mounting options, as you guys could see over here on the paper. Pretty simple. I'm going to go with this style. This compressor came with the bracket, because you could either get a separate where nothing's connected, or the easy mount. Obviously, that's the one I went with. So let's throw it on, see how it goes. You know why we are opening this? We are done installing the air compressor, the airbags, the whole system. Look at that. Man, this place is a mess. Got wires everywhere, tools everywhere. So what I did is I mounted the air compressor right there. Right there. Let me get my light. There it is. You could put it on the frame. It's technically on the frame, or it's on the frame support, or whatever you want to call it. It's a little higher than it would usually be right here. So I want to tuck it up as high as I can right behind the cab, and then connected all the wires. I ran them. I mean, it's so simple. You just gotta, you know, throw zip ties, run them through the airbags. They come with these splice things, or whatever you want to call this, connectors. You plug it in here, plug it in there, and then run the extra one to the airbag. That's it. And then I ran the wires all along the frame, along the bottom. Then I brought them up to the top, and then put the negative one right there, you know, your fuse, positive. I mean, it's super simple. There's nothing to it. You know, I was a little nervous at first, because I really never did anything like that for a long, long time. And it's way easier than it looks. You know, you get the equipment, you get the boxes, there's wires and bolts everywhere, but it's just step by step. Just watch the video, read the instructions. And then another thing is I already paired the remote. Yes, sir. Just hit that. You guys can see the airlift, 5 pounds in there. So let's get underneath the truck and put some air in there, show you how fast it works. It's easy, just click, 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 click. You could program this to whatever setting you want, so that's 20 pounds. I could see the truck actually picking up a little bit. It wasn't 5 before. There you go. Just put 15 extra pounds in here. So pretty simple. Yeah, you can feel them. So ran the wire, the hose right there. That connector's right there. Yep, there's air in them. Then you just hit it again, it turns back on. Can't really see, it says 20 on there though. Let's drop it back to 15, I mean to 5. Wait a second. Okay. Boom, that's it. Back to 5. Yeah, so way softer. Yeah, that's pretty much it. It's not that difficult to do. Not that difficult as I thought it's gonna be. But we're gonna clean up right now, put everything away, and then probably go for a test drive empty on some rough roads. Run it first on 5 pounds, and then run it on 20 pounds, see if there's a difference. All right guys, check this out. This is Sam's hitch. These chain supports. Thanks man, I appreciate you lending them to me, because when I got the truck, by the time we finished with the whole thing, this paperwork and stuff, the parts department was closed and I couldn't buy the ball, so I had to order one online. And this one is a 2 5/16 ball. Well, check this out, it just came in the mail. Let me show you guys. Oh man. Dude, look at that. That's my hand right there. Look how big this thing is. It's 3 inch compared to that one. Dude, this thing is massive. Let me take that one now, put them side to side. Well, I just had to take my gloves off and get this tool, because the biggest drawback with this system is the way it works. As you can see right here, That's how you lock and unlock it. So in order to take it out, you gotta grab the ball and your hands are gonna get all greasy. But this thing was kind of stuck. I think there's too much grease underneath. So I had to kind of pry it up. But I think before I get my gloves dirty, I'm gonna take off those chain things and put my new ones in, and then I'll replace the ball. All right, nicely put away in the box, 2 5/16 ball, and then these chain holders, safety things, and then all the accessories, I guess, goes in here. That's kind of cool, I guess. Cover up the hole. I like how this comes with the box. Mine didn't. I don't know why the 3 inches don't come in the box. I tried to find one. I couldn't find it on e-trailer. That's where I got it for some reason. Oh, I gotta show you the side-by-side, but there it is. I'll grab this one. I mean, dude, this thing's huge. It's rated for 38,000. This one is rated for 30. So I guess I had extra. Let's take this out. I mean, I don't know if you guys could see, but dude, this thing is huge. The neck part is probably almost the size of this ball. Dude, that is massive. I need something like that for my desk. One thing I don't like that it spins, kind of moves around. I hate that. I talked to a guy, he has the same truck, and he said he actually welded the ball in because, I mean, it's a tow rig. He's not going to take it out ever, and it's just better because you could feel it sometimes moving around. It's kind of annoying, but it is what it is. But dude, look at this thing. Oh my God. It's like one of those custom semi-shifters. Yeah, so I'm gonna wait for my brother. He's gonna come over and gonna help me take off that 2 5/16 coupler off the trailer. Because when I picked up the gooseneck, I also grabbed the 3-inch setup. Let me show you the old one. You guys probably seen it in other videos, but right here. They custom made it for me at Diamond C. Great company. And there is this fifth wheel or kingpin attachment for a fifth wheel. It actually goes into this coupler, and this coupler already has a BX 3-inch ball adapter. So, and this thing actually has one of those balls in here, and that one doesn't. It's flat, so this one's gonna be a little easier to connect to, because on this truck you could just look backwards and you see the ball, but on that truck, you know, you got that. Or on that truck, you have all that crew cab space and you can't really see, so you gotta rely on the cameras, and it works, you know. I hit it almost all every single time, but it's just easier that way. But with this one, you don't have to be dead on. All right, so we just put this one on. Look at that. I think it kind of looks better, huh?
Slowly.
Looks a little better. I mean, the rust coupler had a story to it. People would ask me, and, you know, I could say what happened. But this one kind of looks nice too. So, and like I was saying earlier, I like how this thing has a cup. See a little better now outside. Really excited to use this one. This thing is solid. So we're gonna bolt it in, and then go from there. Put that top one in. Not through it. This thing is a must, because I think one of them we have to hit. Oh, we should look, we could actually hit them all, because it doesn't have that.
Oh, that's really
the side. Yeah, we could actually hit them all. Although on the other one, it has these two things where you gotta adjust, and we couldn't hit it with this big boy. That's one thing I hate about the Pittsburgh. Maybe it's actually this, because as a ring, it doesn't have a hole on it. Yeah.
going on good?
Yeah.
I guess good for now. Alright, so the 3-inch coupler is on. This is the original one that the trailer actually had. We took this one off and put on the other one. They're all in. Yeah, so let's go see how she does. Alright guys, so we're on this street that is extremely bumpy. I'm gonna hit the bumps on purpose. This thing rides so much better than that cab chassis. That's just a side note. Probably said that 100 times. Okay. Not too bad, not too bad. So we're gonna go to the stop sign, then throw 45 pounds in the bags. And then we're gonna come back, turn around, and then head down that road again. All right, so there it is. Let me turn it on. 5 pounds in here. So let's take it up to 45 pounds. So I'll stand next to it. Well, it's airing up, but you can't really see it go up. Alright, so here they are extended on 45 pounds. Higher than that, so let's go.
Jump in.
This remote is super comfortable. Just throw it right there. Throw it in gear. Put the seatbelt on. Okay, it's gonna start beeping at you. My Ford didn't have any of those beepers. It looks like it's way steeper. The nose of it.
Damn.
It's kind of one of those trucks that kind of sits like that. Cali lean, but the opposite direction. So that's the Cali lean, so I guess that's the East Coast lean. Oh man.
Hell of that.
Dude, this thing. Wow. You could definitely feel the bags. Oh!
Damn, this feels just like the Ford.
Yeah. Alright, let's hit this side. Oh yeah, there's a major difference in how it rides. So I'm gonna go back to the shop and then we're back to the yard. And then see if it's leaking any. Just shut the truck down and just listen quietly and see how it goes. But yeah, what do you think?
It's a big difference. It's crazy.
Yeah, so it's going to be nice once we hook it up to the trailer. It's going to sag. I think it sags like almost 2 inches. But when it sags 2 inches, the truck sits level. Because I think this thing has a tow, because of the tow package, it naturally sits up higher than the rear. You could see it. But once you put that trailer on there, it sits level, but then if you put a heavy load, you know, on the front of the trailer, it sags even more. So, super excited to tow with it. All right, so we got the tape measure out right there. So 14 and a half inches, 14 and a half. So we're gonna sit for a minute and see if the bags are gonna be leaking, and then we're gonna drain it.
See how she rolls.
All right, got all the air out of it. We're at it right there. 13 and a half. So it dropped an inch. With 45 pounds, nothing on the bed, it goes up 1 inch. Not bad. All right, first test connecting. As you guys can see how much it's off? It's not even aligned. It's gonna fall.
Boom.
See? The other one, that would have happened. I mean, I knew right away when I was pulling up to the ball that it's gonna happen. I just wanted to test out the coupler, show you guys. Because look at that. When I have to connect, super close. I'm gonna have to go on the other side of the fence and actually move it over because it's way too close. All right, well, truck and trailer's back at the house. So me and Paula ran down to get fuel for the truck because it was almost empty, and we were playing with the air compressor, and it seems like between 15 and 20 pounds with an empty trailer seems right. 25 was too rough,
but between 20 and 15. So I still gotta put, it's gonna take a couple days to figure out exactly what's what, but I am very excited because I'm very happy with the airbag system. It's working great, nice and wireless. That 3-inch ball and the coupler, just kind of getting things done. So now we gotta put Linux on the bed and then install the fuel tank / toolbox. And yeah, go from there. Let me know in the comments below what you guys like, what you guys wanna see, and what you guys think about it. So like always guys, have a blessed day. See you on the next one.